Hello everybody and welcome to the next episode of RogueTech. Today we are rebuilding a little bit because our our trebuchet got wrecked last turn. The XL engine got destroyed and as a result the treb was down. However, we got it back from the battlefield and I'm super happy about that. We also have the basilisk in the progress and I have a feeling that I want to build that today. So let's bring that big catapult on the battlefield and see what we can do with it, right? Right, that's what we're gonna do. In the meantime though, I wanna quickly go to the store because I have an idea. I wanna sell some equipment, and I know that a lot of you are already cheering up right now, because I really wanna go in and upgrade my mech bay. Because mech bay means 3 mechs repaired at the same time, plus 7 tech points or so, and I want to get that. So let's quickly get rid of some stuff here so that we can afford it. I'm gonna sell one of the Gauss rifles here, the large laser, large pulse. I'm not using that so often or at all. We got a bunch of mediums, we're gonna keep like 5. ER medium, sell that. Pulse laser, got enough of them. Let's keep 3, why not? And LRM 10, let's get rid of that. LRM 15, I'm gonna keep one LRM 15 and I'm gonna tell you in a second why. Actually, do I? No, I'm not. Mm-mm. No, absolutely not. We're gonna get there, guys. No machine guns. No, this. The plasma rifle I find interesting. I'd rather sell the PPCs and the ER PPCs and the light PPCs and the light rifle and the rocket launchers. Guys, trust me, I'm an engineer. I know what I'm doing. I mean, most of the time. And yes, I'm a literal, legitimate engineer. I got an engineer's degree, so... Okay, armor primitive, let's get rid of that. Case, let's get rid of that. Cockpit DNI, I want to keep that. This engine is just double the weight, let's sell it. Let's sell 2 of that. We got 2 fusion core 110, 4 fusion core 155. I think I'm going to keep the rest. For the sake of having something when I need it, when I find a new mech that I want to instantly outfit, and then having a fusion core lying there is good. I got a bunch of gyros, 1 ultralight, I think I'm gonna keep that as well. A bunch of double heat sinks, actually only 1. And patchwork materials, endo steel, why not? And we can get rid of 1 supercharger. So that's gonna be it for the moment. Now, ship upgrades. As I was saying, I want the 3rd mech bay. 3 mechs at once. That is what we want to do. Will take some days, but we also will take some days to wait for the mechs to be repaired. So let's go ahead and do that. And then we're gonna refit the trebuchet and the catapult. Ooh, power spike. All right. What's that? Just got a power spike in the med bay, Samira announces. What? Must have fried something. Okay, the power is out down here. A few minutes later, Darius and Dr. Murad are discussing the options. It's a major relay. To replace it, I'll need to shut down everything connected to it for several hours. You will have life support, but not much else. I cannot afford this. Can we just repair the relay without shutting everything down? Possibly, but I wouldn't recommend that approach. We'd likely just be putting the med-based problem off to deal with later. Okay, we're gonna get assistance from the local repair facility. Repair med bay without shipwide power shutdown. Do we need the med bay right now? I don't know what that does. It's 40,000. I think we can afford it. Maybe it gives us some morale as well, or maybe we get a tech point for some days or something. Let's see. No, we just lose money. Okay, anyway, I'm not reading this. I just want to keep going. I'm so excited about the basilisk. Okay, trap is ready. And as a result, I'm gonna put that in storage. Good night. So, why did I do that? Because I wanted the stuff in there. And the basilisk is ready in 16 days. That means the financial report is kicking in now and then we can refit it. Yeah, I think we're gonna get there. Also, guys, Enforcer. I have an idea for the Enforcer. Look at this. We have a Gauss rifle and a medium laser here. And the plasma cannon there. And I have a feeling that the plasma cannon missed a lot. So what I want to do is I want to bring this arm weapon actuator +++. It tells us +3 arm mounted accuracy, -2 recoil and -2 melee accuracy. Which is good, right? So, weapon actuators are a collection of specialized servos and compensators allowing a battlemech's armed mounted weapons to fire with greater accuracy. Reduces melee, improves arm mounted weapons. So, we're gonna change the lower arm actuator here. We have one ton too much now, but you know what? If I just do this, we should be fine, right? So, let's play it like that. Heat management is good. 41 heat sinking, 45 alpha strike heat. That's a delta of 4, which is super good. Are we gonna play without or with one medium laser less now? I think this is definitely okay. 210 engine. Could we upgrade it a bit more? Is that possible? Deny cockpit is nice to have. Wait. Targeting system for energy. Oh, we could upgrade that even more. To get the plasma cannon on point more often. Ah, let's go. Let's just play this. Here we go. Right. So, yeah, as I was saying, the Basilisk, the big upscaled catapult. What you could do with that technically is, since it has all of the hard points in the world, I wanted to build a mag shot build with, like, I think we can put in 11 mag shots, 11 ballistic hard points, and then the same amount of medium lasers. Ready to go. Okay, I could press enter. I couldn't see the button anymore. Okay. But yeah, just a ridiculous amount of tiny one-ton weapons. And then heat sinks. I'd like to play that so, so badly. But anyhow, let's play it. Let's build it. And I already have an idea how to do it. So the catapult is having a basic setup already with two LRM-20. 3 tons of ammo. Might be a little bit too little, but yeah, what we can do now, technically, is we could put in this and then upgrade ammo and then go crazy on that and just go full LRM. However, we could also, as I was saying, it has a bunch of hard points and we could do anything we want. We could put in a plasma rifle. We could also just put in this. And I think this is the idea that I like the most. So we have a Gauss rifle, 2 LRM-20, and we're gonna take some Gauss ammo here. I actually have to buy another ton on the store. Where is it? Gauss, thank you. New equipment. I almost available. Broke again. So let's do something like that. We cannot, I believe, put lower arm actuators in here because it's the catapult. Can we? Arm actuator, right arm only supports the upper arm actuator, yeah. So it's not possible that you can modify this mech so much that it gets lower arm actuators. Would be nice. So, DNI cockpit, of course, for reducing the damage by 10%. We are running XL. Keep that in mind, guys. We got one of these cooling ports. I think I have another one. Yep. Minus 3% heat generated. Oh god, so good. And minus 4 heat per turn. This is really good. Also, we have single heat sinks here. 10 out of 10. That's good. And what I also want is I want to not use ferrofibrous. It only reduces 2 tons, or weight by 2 tons. I want endosteel. Yeah, I know. Get out of here. Endosteel. Now we are fine. And this is basically a build. We could go a little bit riskier if we went for ferro and take composite structure. Because composite structure doesn't take any slots, but it reduces the inner structure by 50%. Running an XL. It's risky, but we have 160 armor on the front and then 40 structure in there. I want to try. I know it's super risky, but I want to do it anyway. What I also want is a tag, guys. Let's take a tag. Why the tag? Because we're probably gonna multi-target a lot, and when we're going for the kill shot with the Gauss rifle on a tank and the LRMs on another target, then we can even tag a third target and set it up for the kill next turn. So, having the tag is super good. Apart from it, heat management, let me check. That's perfect. 2.5 tons. Medium lasers? Huh? What do you think, guys? One medium laser? One more heat sink, maybe? Regular medium? What about this? Does it do anything? You know what, we're gonna take another ton of ammo. I think that medium laser is not gonna come in handy at all. We have Artemis ammo equipped already. Got another ton of LRM ammo here. And the heat management, as I was saying, is glorious. We are heat neutral. So we could upgrade the leg armor. Which we should probably do. a bit of back armor so that we add one ton. And if we can get another support system, that would be great. Something like a targeting system. We don't have any for ballistics or for missile weapons. Damn it. It's not much that I can take. You know what? I'm gonna take the medium laser. It's crazy, I know. But it's something that we can add here. So I'm gonna take the extended range because the build is more or less long range oriented. And at some point, it might come in handy. If it's not coming in handy, so be it. Alright, Sabercat arrives at your quarters looking for some advice. What it started as a competitive training exercise in the training module has since evolved into a ship-wide tournament with mixed lances of mech warriors and other crew. Sabercat and Gearhead have been competing together. But Commander, Gearhead hasn't been pulling his weight, and my other two teammates are looking to me as lance captain to do something about it. I'm feeling a bit stuck here, what should I do? Extra practice. Sure, let's go. No! You're right, now's the time for everyone to step up. Later that week, you visit a training room and check the leaderboards. Sabercat's lance has fallen in the standings. Gearhead walks up behind you. Commander, I know you encouraged Sabercat to keep me around. I feel bad that I let him down. But I think that I need a life or death adrenaline from the real battlefield. Anyway, please know that I won't let you down. Not when it counts, anyway. Okay. Okay, Gearhead is in low spirits. 4 days until the Basilisk is ready and we are only 11 minutes into the video, guys. I'm sorry, but it's just the way it goes. And now we're gonna finally drop on the battlefield. I want to take the 2.5 skull mission here just as a practice. And I want to negotiate for 400,000 and 3 out of 14 salvage because I believe that we can get some nice stuff off the battlefield. This is our classic setup. Now with the Enforcer having the lower arm actuator upgrade. And of course, we have the Basilisk! If we could get a command console, I'd definitely put it into the Basilisk. I believe the higher initiative is coming in handy so much. Also, it is a mech with a lot of weapons, probably gets a lot of kill, and therefore the morale gain is nice, and all of the other things as well. I think we also have one injury resist or something. I don't know, it's just good. The initiative alone is worth it. So, 5 tons actually, so 2 tons higher than a regular cockpit. It's definitely worth it. We didn't know what to do with the weight anyway, right? Okay. Oh yeah, I've been playing on this planet before. So, here we go. Yeah, right, so we have mechs and vehicles here. AC-20 axle, Okay. RIP APCs. Run, guys, run! And after we finish with them, there is a dropship coming in here, I believe, and then engaging the turrets and the buildings from here. I want to try to ace the mission and get all of these secondary objectives done. So let's see if we can do that. Would be great. So, I do not want to step away too far from the base, so I let them come. Very important. Because at some point, I want to turn around and engage these guys that are coming from this direction. So let's play rather stand than shooty. Here we go. Yeah, APCs running away from the tank. I'm super happy to see that. Because if the APCs arrive in the base, then we will also get turret support, which would help us massively. SRM Trebuchet. Okay. And what's that? Missiles. Seems like an LRM-10. Maybe a Griffin? Okay. Behemoth, show your new actuator here. Okay, yeah. On my way. Ooh, what's that? AC-10 plus. Yeah, I think we're gonna go for the tank first. Although the plasma cannon is not doing so much in terms of heat management, it still opens up, hopefully, a component. Oh god, maybe not. Behemoth. The enemy is in front of you, not right next to you, okay? Next time, yeah, I know that you need to get used to that actuator that you have there. However, could you please aim better?
Damage is minor.
Right, damage is minor.
Yes, Commander.
Inferno. No, actually, let's use Sabercat and see what we can do with him. This is an obstructed line of sight here, sadly. Can we get direct line of sight? We can. Yeah, let's get on the high ground. and shoot everything. Let's see what connects. Wait. Also, we are heat neutral. Did I break the build? It stated something like 58 heat buildup and 30 something heat dissipation. Okay, that's interesting. That is very interesting. Sadly, the Gauss rifle missed. And we got some LRMs coming in. And his structure is exposed. Good. These are the missiles from the tank. He's not shooting his AC, which I'm happy about. So where could I get direct line of sight? I can not. Nope. Only here. Alright guys, gambling on the Gauss. That's what we do. 22%. Shoot the lasers as well, I don't care.
I copy.
So it's inverted day today. The low hit chances hit, the high hit chances miss. Yep. That's what we do. Is he tagged already? He is tagged already. Where would I go? Probably intercepting these guys down there. Yep. Yeah, we sprint up here. It's okay. We are in the woods. We are evasive. Should be fine. Okay. Next turn. Wait. Are they not gonna act first? I thought so. I mean, I was the last to move. That means that the enemy should be the first to start. I'll take it, because that means that I can finish the trip. The trebuchet. Can we? Somehow? No? Okay. Is Behemoth gonna do it then? Yes. So, that's a good hit chance. The Gauss rifle is pretty bad, though. What's wrong? Ah, refire. Okay, yeah, sure. That's still a thing. That's a lot of recoil. It also states weapon accuracy plus 3. What? It doesn't state on the plasma cannon. Is it just a regular weapon accuracy? What is this? I thought the lower arm actuator would be negative, would make it easier to hit, and now it says it adds the difficulty here. Shot modifier plus 6. Huh. Alright. Okay. Whatever. We're gonna shoot. And hope. I really need to reread this lower arm actuator, or the Gauss rifle in general. Maybe it's supposed to work like that. But it didn't state it before I aimed for the shot. Okay. Anyhow, the guy's on the ground, and that is what matters. And we can now follow up with anything. I want to put Medusa up here on the right side. To again intercept the tank and intercept the whatever that mech is. And then we're gonna leave the other mechs, mech warriors on the left, to intercept the guys that are coming from the left. Very important. Oh, it's a Centurion. Light Gauss rifle. Rockets. A lot of them. And an LRM. Okay, APC is holding up.
What's up, boss?
Yeah, what's up? Nothing. Aye, aye. So far. We're gonna reserve here. So I want to let them come closer, and then we're gonna see what we can do. Why not? Aha. They are reserving with me. Got big tank. Misses his AC-10. And the Enforcer is getting some minor damage, which is okay.
Yeah.
That also means that Medusa can do this now.
Copy that.
Let's go, Medusa! Go, Medusa! Yeah, there we go. Yeah, he's dead! Stop! You can stop firing. You don't need to do that anymore. He's just dead, okay?
Over down.
Thank you. That bloodlust. Okay, we forced the tank to come in. We're gonna reserve once more.
Holding for the right opportunity.
And it seems that... Yeah, the mech has moved, the tank has moved. The cooldown turn here.
Affirmative.
Brace. Ooh! Sensor log. Thank you very much, Mr. Turret. That's great. Okay, that means that we can just shoot indirectly with our LRMs. Just softening that guy up a bit. That's sensor lock. Guys, I really want sensor lock on Sabercat. He's working towards that right now, being my tactician, my tactic specialist. And having at least one mech warrior that has that is probably worth a lot, especially in such a situation here. When you don't really want to engage yet, when you want them to come closer, but you can take a snapshot by firing indirectly.
Receiving you.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, shall I go in? Yeah, 46% is good enough. Hey, dude. Hey, I got the Gauss rifle.
Aye, aye.
You almost lost your torso. Okay, lower arm actuator destroyed. Mm-hmm.
Critical hit, Commander.
Messes with his aim now. APC does nothing.
Waiting for orders.
Could probably do a death from above. No, I couldn't. I shouldn't. You know what? We're gonna set up here. And again, wait for them to come on the other side. Is that a kill? Oh, it's a good hit to the knee. It's not enough, though.
Good to go.
So, the problem that Behemoth has is that she's on top of that stupid hill and she cannot get an angle whatsoever, so I use her to sprint down already. And now the tank. I'm so happy that the tank is not shooting his AC-20 whatsoever at all. It's alright.
Receiving you.
And Sabercat. Yeah.
On it.
You wonder why I'm moving? Because I want to set up for the, again, the other side already. Slightly moving into that other direction. Okay, cool. So maybe we can get that guy before anything bad happens. If that turns out well here, what we are doing, guys, I'm gonna do the next mission with, I think it was 3.5 skulls. We gotta see. I don't know yet. Maybe we just grind some money with the one skull, or maybe we go for the higher difficulty mission.
I've got eyes on
the other reinforcements. Okay.
They're heading your way.
Mm-hmm. Wait. They dropped here. Oh, that's new. I thought they were coming in here.
Waiting for order.
All right. I'll take it. In that case, I want to quickly try to destroy that guy.
Acknowledge.
Get wrecked. Heavy Gauss, guys. So good.
Mech destroyed.
Mech destroyed. Now, really, the dropship was landing in around this place. Alright, we gotta go down here then.
Waiting for
Behemoth! Intercept! Please, run! What's coming down there? Also, I have this tank here still. So, can the APC do it? Actually, it is looking solid. So, we might be able to use just Sabercat as the guy who shoots later and finish it off. And as a result, we could bring in the Shadowhawk down here. Again, we have negotiated for a good chunk of money, and therefore keeping all the buildings safe is priority right now. What now? Ooh, lots of movement. Lots and lots of movement. Lots of turn three.
Ready for orders.
Okay. Let's sprint. Yeah, it's okay. 40%. I think we have enough ammo for the late game, so it's not a big deal. So close, though. So close. 28 on the side, 18 on the front. Plus the 5 structure that he has. And he's not doing anything, so the turrets might be the one destroying here. It's another barrage of missiles. Oh my god, you're so bad. There's another barrage of missiles. Come on! Finally! That took a while. Okay. There's nothing on the sensor so far. Aha! I called it. That's this side, not the other one. Alright, so what do we have here? Oh, Ultra 10 Blackjack. That thing can tear buildings apart in no time. Ugh. Any chances? Equals bad.
Copy that.
Okay, let's engage the guy. 33%, it's not that much. Let's see. Maybe inverse day is still up. No, both missed. Okay.
Failed to connect.
Failed to connect. Okay. The good thing is that we have the turrets and the APCs. Let me see. Yeah, double LRM-15. Large laser, medium laser. Ah, there's another mech coming up. It's a hunchback. And double LRM-20. Always. I hope that we can keep these LRM turrets alive for a long time. AC-20 hunchback. It's not really friendly. It's coming up there. Yeah, we got the sprint down here.
Double time. Let's go.
Let's go! So what else is coming? These big pinpoint weapons, I'm mildly afraid of them. Ah, there's the next one. Another hunchback. LRM 20 tag medium laser. Interesting build.
Good to go.
I can start shooting them. And with shooting I mean tagging them.
Confirmed.
Which one is the most important thing to take apart? I believe it's the blackjack.
Engaging the target.
Ah, didn't hit. Didn't connect. And I think they fixed the bug where the tag, yeah, if it doesn't hit, you don't get the bonus anymore. Guarded entrenched. A centurion.
Picked up a blip.
There are mechs coming from down there. What? We're being surrounded. Ooh, the mission is getting tougher than expected, guys. Yeah, we cannot possibly have all of these buildings survive. It's not possible. Yeah, there goes the first building down.
One of our structures has been eliminated.
That doesn't work like that. I mean, if they're coming from these outskirts and shooting long range at the buildings, there's nothing I could have done. Nothing.
Receiving you.
Okay, but we can do something against these guys in general. That is shooting at them. I still wonder why the build is heat neutral. What is going on here?
Confirmed.
We are on a hot planet, and I think I have more Alpha Strike heat than I have dissipation. Maybe it's a glitch on the battlefield, maybe it is some components that were not calculated in the mech lab correctly. I don't know. Oh yeah, give him hell. That's what I want to see. And there's the knockdown. We could also technically do something like double Ultra 10 plus medium lasers on the catapult that we have. But I really like the evasion ignore and the accuracy on the Gauss rifle. That's super good. Okay. So I think what I want to do is I just want to go for some salvage here that I... crap. That I want to get.
What's up, boss?
Uh-huh. Can you sprint down here and kill? Please.
On it.
Please kill. Kill Leg.
All weapons are go.
Let's hit him hard.
Okay.
Take
I think
that.
We did not destroy him. No. Not quite. He's at 14 health. Yep, yep. I need to bring Medusa on the front again. Medusa is so much in on the back line here. Wait, where is he actually? There he is. So, he's so far out, and as a melee mech that is in the outskirts, he's not doing anything.
Ready for orders.
Jumping, sprinting. Sprinting gets us further. We start tagging people. Yeah, we tag the hunchback in front of us.
Engaging
tag. That worked. Okay. I could leave the blackjack on the ground for the turrets, to be honest. But the turrets are gonna act in turn one, which is bad. The blackjack will stand up. I just have the feeling that my heavy gauss is wasted on that guy with 14 HP on the center. I'd rather shoot somebody else. At the same rate, it's the best hit chance that we have.
No target.
Okay. Shoot.
Engaging target.
Okay, 100 damage. Overkill. Good, that's one mech down, at least. The thing is, we only have to survive for 5 rounds here. We gotta make sure that they don't destroy all the buildings. And as soon as we have that, after 5 rounds, it's just over, no matter if there are still enemies around or not. So we don't have to fight it to the end to actually succeed in the mission. Pork. Ooh. Porcupine. It's an upgraded version of the porcupine, or a modified version of the one that we saw before in the playthrough here. It's interesting. What is a pod? What does that do? Pod. I've never seen that. Combat shield, rocket launcher, pod, and machine guns. I'm a little bit afraid of that, I gotta say. I have no idea what it does, and therefore I'm suspicious. Huh. Okay.
Standing by.
Pod. Hmm. Good hit chances on the trebuchet, and moderated chances on the hunchback. Hunchback is mildly damaged already, but you know what? That's a way better target. We might be able to take it out in one go. Also, for the initiative, I'm gonna use the vigilance here. Which... never mind. Which messes with our hit chances because we are not inspired anymore, but holy cow. That was a crit. Nice sensor lock, thank you. AC-20 hunchback. No wait, that's that one. I wanted to see what that guy down below is. Yeah, get the missiles on point. I like this. Is it just me, or do you have that same feeling? That an overabundance of missiles on the battlefield is just so beautiful to watch. It's like a flock of birds flying in the sky, doing somersaults and all kinds of nice formations. It's just so beautiful. Okay, all of our mechs are now turn 3 mechs. Shall I try to get the porcupine? I want to see what that pod is doing. I can get no angle though. Nope. The only angle I can get is against this guy. I would expose my back. Don't like that too much. What's that? Kintaro 2C, guys! Clan mech! Priority salvage! Those are AT freaking M's, advanced tactical missiles. So if they are working as I think they would work, then they would deal more damage the closer that's you get. True. Let's get him. Also, vigilance for the next turn. And of course, not to get destroyed this turn. Yep. Get him! Get him! I need this salvage! And I need it now! Give it to me! Good amount of armor you have there. Holy cow. I don't care about hunchbacks here. I want ATMs, guys. Oh, this is interesting. ATMs. Yeah, come closer, please. Yeah, get line of sight. Yeah, it's not a problem. Ah, shoot the turret. Okay. Oh, nasty turret. Did you see how much damage I dealt? It's 10 damage. 10 damage. Uh-huh.
Standing by.
Dusa can go in. Yo, Dusa. Get him. Where would I attack from? Also, heavy large laser. Clan double heat sinks. XL engine. Ooh, I need to engage from the side. Try to leg him. Maybe that's possible. Give me the salvage. Okay. We destroyed an arm. A bunch of ATMs down. And a knockdown. Wait, what ammo does it use? LRM ammo. Okay, so I'm happy. There's no special ATM ammo, because otherwise we would have a problem if we could salvage the weapon, but not the ammo, because you cannot buy them. So far, I haven't seen it yet. Alright. Completely ignoring what's going on the side there. I have my priority. APC is getting shred. I'm happy with that.
Waiting for orders.
Way to go. Over here.
I copy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the legs, of course.
Locking in all weapon systems.
It's a good hit. It's not a destruction, though. Holy cow. You are sturdy, man. Okay. I'm just dragging it out. Also, it would be actually good if we didn't destroy more mechs, because that would just clutter up the loot table. And, yeah. We don't want that, actually. Okay. Let's go over here.
Whoop. Going full throttle.
Going full throttle. Shoot! One leg down. Oh, that's the ATM down. I might...
Target's taken a critical hit.
Okay. I mean, yeah. That was a bit of overkill, I gotta say. The Butcher Vindicator. Hello, Butcher. Oh, fresh meat. Uh-huh. It's Plasma Cannon, Flamer, SRM6, Laser Drill. I've never seen a Laser Drill before. Oh, our melee mod, 20% damage. Would be something nice for the Shadowhawk. And melee accuracy. That's nice. No, 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 don't destroy! Come on, at least leave me the heavy laser. Ooh, don't. Oh, engine destroyed. Okay. Okay, rip, trebuchet. Let's see what we can salvage there. Three rounds. I want to kill the Butcher. It's probably dropping the cleaver here. So, let's see if we can get some uniques for our mech. And by the way, guys, I'm just talking trash. That's a Diablo reference. Okay, okay. Let's kill him. Right from the back. This guy has some good stuff that I want. Sadly, it was not enough to destroy the engine in one go. Damn it. And he's still upright and he's still standing. Shouldn't be the case. No, leave him alone. It's my target. Knocked down at least. Uh-huh. What's he running there? Ah, regular cockpit mod. Okay. 12 damage. 12 damage. What the hell was that? Did you hear that? That sounded not right.
Commander.
Okay. We're gonna use Behemoth. Yes, jump up here or sprint up here to get an angle on this guy. We grind through the center torso then, and we not shoot the medium. Still, the Gauss rifle with such a bad hit chance. It's probably the recoil that is kicking in hard.
On it.
Mm-hmm. Stressed. I like the mission, guys. Clan Max! So good. So, pod. What does a pod do? ABM. No idea. I've never seen that. I have no idea what it is. I have no idea what it does. So, we might destroy that thing to see it on the loot table and make a decision if we want that or not. Yeah, you go ahead and shoot the turrets. I don't care.
Ready for orders.
Yep. Can I get on high ground somehow? No. I mean, this is not a good idea, right? Exposing the back to all of these guys, now that they have destroyed most of the turrets. Nah, we're not gonna do that. We do that.
Position confirmed.
Vigilance here. And do the cold shot to the center. With everything. Let's go. Okay. Yeah, he's dead. It's fine.
Tango down.
What about the amount of ammo? I believe it's just enough. In terms of LRM ammo that we have here. What the hell? What? It's time. No. No.
Light damage.
What was that? One-shot weapons. But why is my plasma crit? Guys, can you tell me why my plasma is crit?
Yes, Commander.
Holy cow! Holy cow!
Full speed.
Oh, that was ridiculous. Oh my god. Okay. I just want to get away from these guys. If I get a shot in, that's fine. We need to survive for 3 more rounds. It's okay. That was ridiculous. Okay, is he gonna go down? Not quite. Okay, we got a crit on the gyro though, and his AC-20 is without ammo because he lost his side torso, which is here. AC-20 ammo in the left side and the AC-20 in the right side. So you lose either side torso and you are basically off the battlefield. Okay.
Waiting for order.
Medusa, can you please do something about this weird, weird little cicada?
Coordinates received.
Thank you.
Locked on for physical attack.
Yeah, one of the plasmas crit, therefore the lower hit chances. But why? I don't get it. Panicked. Okay. So two more rounds and then we are off this mission here. Although I would say we could have played it to the end. I wouldn't mind. But these hunchbacks here, it's actually better if they don't get destroyed.
Receiving you.
So, what to do? We're gonna bring Behemoth first. The Gauss rifle doesn't like point blank, so we're gonna stay a bit away from this guy and then shoot everything that is right arm mounted. Not the medium laser.
Solid connection on that one.
All right, that's the knockdown. Thing is also very sturdy. 100 armor is on the side, is pretty good for a porcupine. Cicada 40 ton mech. Sure. Okay. It's not doing anything because of the heat. Which means that we can just kill this. Oh my god, that was so ridiculous. The whole mission is so ridiculous. I think we're gonna shoot this.
Affirmative.
Come on, get panicked. You can just go home, dude.
Standing by.
There's no need to fight. You just go. Or I kill you. I can't. Okay, I'm gonna kill you. If you say so, you don't want to go home, you gotta deal with the consequences, which are having 7 HP left. Damn. So this porcupine is basically just going in, unleashing hell at close range, and then doing what? Shooting this machine gun array. After that, I mean after everything, after the rockets, after the ports are empty. Huh.
Watch the flank. Watch the flank.
It's a lot of damage. Alright. So, 7 damage is what we need. And one more turn. Lots and lots of impacts. Alrighty. Cool. So. No, no, not you. I wanna shoot. Guys, I'm so happy that we have the turrets here as our basically first layer of defense. These guys were so busy shooting the turrets all the time. Imagine all of the shots coming to my mech warriors.
Yes, Commander.
There's a lot of targets on the battlefield there that we have to take out.
On it.
Shut down. Oh, that's nice. Shut down and knocked down. Is that the death of the pilot? Yeah. Okay. Good. So, one more round. I don't think that they can destroy everything here. Like, we have still a bunch of military buildings. It's gonna be alright. Still their turn, though. I just wanna shoot again, just for shenanigans. Let's see if we can just rip something apart. What do you think about the catapult build? The basilisk build here. Is that cool?
Yes, Commander.
I like it, I gotta say. Okay. Heavy Gauss for the win! Run in and shoot. I wanna see. Like this?
Kapow. Engaging.
Oh. Sad face. Still APCs on the board. Okay. Behemoth. We could technically, actually, thinking about it, I could just technically only shoot or use the plasma cannon, like two plasma cannons in one arm, because the Gauss is, it's really tough here.
Firing.
Getting that on point.
Yo, dude, there's something falling off of your mech. You should really consider bringing that back when you're meeting with your mech tech again. And complain about that arm actuator not holding tight. Seriously. The amount of ammo is, I would say, just about right. Speaking of LRM ammo here, so we can Alpha Strike once more. And after that, we set up the Gauss and the medium laser. Maybe one more ton would be nice. One ton. So beautiful. But the mission is complete. Woo! What a mission, guys! What a mission! Woo, that was intense. It wasn't really that we were under pressure, but I wanted to get the good stuff off the battlefield and the monies. And the monies are good here, I gotta say. Mm-hmm. Got some kills, actually. So, Kintaro 2C, Quirk Clan Mech, whatever that means. Oh, all the hard points. Interesting, but we are not here for getting medium mechs. I'm not fiddling around with medium mechs anymore. I want that ATM-12. What about that, guys? Because the 7 tons deals... Wait, what? Wait, what? 12 by 12? Seriously? Okay, and then again, the closer you get, the more damage you will deal. I like, this is the maximum damage, and the further you are away, the less damage you will deal. But 12 by 12. Just so much. So much. Alright, what's the laser drill? I want to see. 30 damage, 20 heat, 7 stability damage, burners versus overheat. Yeah, okay. So, it would be a nice upgrade to my plasma torches, actually. Yeah, it is. Let's see what else we can get. A heavy laser. Mm-hmm. 90 damage for 4 tons. I mean, the heat is redonkulous, but let's take it. I don't know what to do with that yet, but I want that. Medium laser. It's nice to have. LRM 10. Yeah, sure. Pod. So, what is that? Solaris Arms. Okay. An anti-personnel pod is a piece of equipment designed specifically for mechs. When detonated, effectively fills an area, 50 meters in diameter with deadly shrapnel. Okay. Oh, that it is. So pod A, 0.5 tons, 2 times 10 damage. And some good stability damage. B, 0.75 tons. 4 times 10. Oh, 10 times 4, actually. And M? It's 10 times 6. Okay. Interesting. So this thing is just basically a walking suicide bomber, more or less. You just go in and then, bam! Shrapnel everywhere. I like that idea. SRM-6? Yup. AMS, laser AMS, no thank you. It's just too hot. I don't think that the heat generated is needed here. Low arm actuators, ooh, melee accuracy. It's nice, but I think we don't need more accuracy, we need more punch on the Shadowhawk. So, I believe this is good. Oh, plus 20% damage and 1 accuracy? I know this thing is worth nothing. It's worth 80,000, but it will help us so much. Ammo, Pharaoh Lamellar. Minus 20% damage taken. Plus 30% structure. Minus 12% ammo. What the hell? Okay, that's some weird clan tag. It reduces the damage taken by 20%. Gives you more structure, but reduces your overall armor. This is so good defensive-wise. Screw the heavy laser. I want that lamellar armor thingy. Give me that. This is so OP. So damn OP. Cockpit, breaching shot. Sensor sight, oh my god. DNI cockpit, targeting computer. Oh, I want that so bad. I also want the ATMs and the melee damage. Is it worth it? Plus 1 accuracy, minus 1 recoil. Would be so good for the Enforcer at the moment. Combat shields. Defense gyros. Are we just gonna gamble on that? Clan double heat sinks. Sure. Two slots, 6 heat per turn. Nice. We got a mask. We got clan endo steel. Only takes up 7 slots. Gives you 50% structure weight reduction. Okay. Okay. Good. Good. If you say so. I gotta take the clan endo steel. It's just so good. A ballistic targeting computer. Okay, let's see what we can get. Okay. Mm-hmm. We got the ATM. Sure. Laser drill. Nice. Plasma cannon. Pods. Bunch of them. We got the melee accuracy and melee hit. Ah, this is just a regular arm. Mm-hmm. Hand actuator, actually. Lamellar Pharaoh and Clan Ender Steel. We're gonna upgrade our mechs with Clan Tech, guys. That's gonna be great. But I just took a look at the time, and it says that this episode of RogueTech is over already. Sorry, guys, only one mission today, but you can look forward to the next one. It's gonna be great. And if you like that one here, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I hope to see you guys next time. Goodbye.